Okay, some of the students have asked how we have got this Tn by 2 plus Tn by 2 over here. There were some doubts which have been asked by the students. So I would like to tell you again here, this is a recursive algorithm, right? This is recursive. Recursive means we just keep on calling the same function again and again, right? So what we are doing here, again, there is some condition which needs to be satisfied. What is that condition? If n is greater than or equal to 1, n has got some value, right? So written a of n by 2 plus a of n by 2. Now this a of n by 2, how much amount of time it will take for execution? T n by 2. Right. What about this a of n by 2? Means we are calling the same function again, right? So this how much amount of time it will take? T n by 2. So it will become 2 t n by 2. Then there was asked that 2 t n by 2 plus c. What does this c stand for? They are asking. So, what is this C stand for? C stands for the constant. Constant, we have declared something if n is equal to 100 or if n, int n is equal to 200. So, those are the constants, right? That constant will need to be executed once or two. Executed in the sense, it will be passed, right? So, it will be taking one iteration or two iteration or not the iteration, it will take one unit of time, two unit of time. So, that is constant. Why we are getting this constant? How come we are getting the constant? That when we are declaring your variables over here, those variables need to be, the compiler will be passing through it, right? So it will take some constant amount of time, right? Again, if condition needs to be tested, so again for that there will be some amount of time which will be spent by the compiler for checking the condition. So that is nothing but the constant. Okay, so this C stands for that. Okay, are you getting my point? So C stands for that, whereas this A of n by 2 plus A of n by 2, here this will take T of n by 2. T of n by 2 means what? T denotes here the time complexity, right? Means amount of the time which is taken by the algorithm to execute. So that is, this A of n by 2 loop will take T of n by 2 plus T of n by 2, so it will be becoming 2 T n by 2 plus T. So I hope this doubt gets clear. It was asked last time, okay? Now here, one more. There was one more. Now some of the students asked that they have not understood the back substitution method. So what is this back substitution method? There is one example which I had given you. See here, A of n is nothing but the algorithm. If n is greater than 1, there is some condition, right? The condition needs to be tested or checked, right? So this is nothing but a C. Written A of n minus 1. A of n minus 1 means it will be how many number of times this will be executed. So this will be executed for T of n minus 1 number of times, right? It will check for the condition, yes. N is, let's say, if n is 100, okay, 100 is greater than 1, yes. So this will be executed for 99 units of time, right? Now, A of 99 again it is checked. 99 it is greater than 1, yes. 99 greater than 1, then it will be executed for A of 98. A of 98, okay, it will be passed. If it, recursively it will be called. Okay, 97 it is greater than 1, yes. Then it's A of 96. So here, for checking this particular condition, and if I am declaring something here, right, like, if I am declaring here n is equal to, let's say, 100, so this will take some constant amount of time, right? One unit of time. This will be taking 1 unit of time. So this becomes 2. So this 2 is nothing but here. This 2 plus T of n minus 1, that may be 99. T of 99, okay, that will be T of 100. That will be T of 100. T of 100 is equal to 2 plus T of 99, right? So T of 100 is equal to 2 plus 99. Now here, so similar to that, how we have derived this equation? How we have derived this mathematical equation here? So that's why the solution for this time complexity becomes total amount of time complexity becomes T of n is equal to C. C is nothing but some constant that we have seen. 2 plus T of 98. Okay. So let's say 2 plus T of 98, 99, whatever. So that means it becomes T of n is equal to 1 plus T of n minus 1. Yes, t of n minus 1 will get 1 plus t of n minus 2. T of n minus 2 will get 1 plus t of n minus 3. Like that. Getting it? So I have explained you. 97 will be passed, then it will be 96. Right? Likewise. So t of n will be 1 plus t of 100 will be 1 plus 99, t of 99. T of 99 is equal to 1 plus t of 98. T of 98 is equal to 1 plus t of 97. Okay. Now, apply the back substitution method. I hope you have already studied it in 12th, 10th, whatever standard. But back substitution method is nothing but, this is the equation, right? This is the equation.
Wait a minute.
This is the equation, right? So whatever t of n minus 1 was there, this t of n minus 1 value 1 plus t of n minus 2 is substituted over here. Okay, 1 plus t of n minus 2 is substituted at the place of t of n minus 1. Right? This, at the place of t of n minus 2, this 1 plus t of n minus 3 is substituted. Right? So at the place of 1 plus t of n minus 4, this t of n minus 3, 1 plus t of n minus 4 is substituted. So how the equation is becoming here? Okay? How the equation is becoming? It is nothing but 4 plus t of n minus 4. It is 4 plus t of n minus 4. It is nothing but k plus t of n minus k. Okay. Now, when it is stopped, what do you mean by the base condition? Base condition means what? Stopping criteria. When this particular loop will stop executing, okay, when it will become n is equal to 1, when n is equal to 1, that time it will stop, no? It will not enter into the loop only. If n is equal to 1, it will not enter into the loop. So that is nothing but, see, the stopping criteria is n, no? It is called as base condition. So what is base condition in this case? At what time it will stop? It will be stopping if n becomes equal to 1. So when it will become 1, when it has, so if n is equal to 100, it has iterated for 99 units of time. Okay? So that many number of times it has iterated, it will stop, right? So here, okay, so this is base condition or stopping criteria. So this stopping criteria is k is equal to n minus 1. Okay, so that means when it has iterated, when n has to be greater, when it will enter into the loop, when n has to be greater than 1, right? If it is becoming equal to 1, it will not enter into the loop. So what is the stopping criteria? K is equal to n minus 1. K is equal to n minus 1. So k, I will substitute it over here. So n minus 1 plus t of n minus 1. So this will, when we solve this, n and n will get cancelled and it is t of 1. T of 1 means what? Time complexity for one single statement execution is nothing but 1 only. Are you getting this? Yes or no? We have substituted this base condition, that is k is equal to n minus 1, into this. So it will get, it will be like n minus 1 plus t of n minus 1. So it will become n minus 1 plus this t of n minus plus 1. So this n gets cancelled, so we will be getting n minus 1 plus 1. This and this gets cancelled, so time complexity becomes, it is equal to n, so it is becoming of t of n. Right? So this way we have got this n over here. So this t of n becomes O of n. It's big order or big O of n. Okay. So this was about back substitution method. Now what we are trying to say over here is that okay. So here, for recursive algorithm, how to derive the time complexity? It will be, there are three methods. One is back substitution, another is recurrence tree method, another is master theorem method. Okay. So one is back substitution. What is back substitution? Back substitution we have seen just now. Okay. This is back substitution. Okay. Then the recurrence tree method. Recurrence tree is again nothing but some kind of pictorial representation of how the things would have happened. Okay, let me explain you this with the help of simple binary search example. Okay, so I will just tell you this recurrence tree method. Recurrence tree method is nothing but a recursive description of a function, right? So, or in other words, it is a description of a function in terms of itself, which keeps on calling itself. Okay, so that is recurrence. Now, let me go to the recurrence tree first, then we will come back to this. We will go do reverse engineering. Okay, we will do reverse engineering. So, let's have a look at this particular thing. So, how it has been derived, how it has been drawn. Okay, now of course I may understand that there may not be the same equal distribution into two halves every time. Okay, but let me explain you this. So now there is one example of binary search, let's say. What is binary search? In binary search, there are, let's say, n number of elements which are given in the array and we need to search for the element, right? We need to search for the element. Now, this binary search applies divide and conquer strategy. Divide and conquer strategy means what? The single problem is divided into sub-problems. It is divided into sub-problems and those sub-problems are solved recursively. Okay. Now, what is the need of solving it recursively? Tell me. What is the need of solving it recursively? And what is the need of dividing the problem into sub-problems? Let me give one example over here that suppose the given array consists of 10 number of elements and I need to search for an element. So, hoping that the array is already sorted, right? Let me annotate it again. Suppose the elements are like this. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Okay. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It is not 89, it is 89. Okay. So now let's say there are 8 elements, or even if it is 7 elements, then also we are considering mid as integer. Okay. So here you can consider any element as mid, provided it has to be truncated to the smallest, nearest integer value. Okay. So here let's say I want to search for the element 9. Okay. I want to search for the element 9. So what would happen in linear search? In case of worst case analysis, it would have taken O of N, right? It would have taken O of N. How come O of N? It would have compared this 9 with each and every element. It would have compared this 9 is equal to, let's say, X, the element which is to be searched. It would have compared here, it would have compared here, here, here. Then it would have come here. Now here only 8 elements are there. But what about if the array is of 1 lakh? If the array is of 1 lakh elements, then it would have taken how much amount of time? O of 1 lakh. Imagine O of 1 lakh, it's a huge time, right? O of 1 lakh, even milliseconds if you take. Okay, it is a huge time. So we cannot afford to give that much amount of time, right? So there are the certain methods which algorithmic design practices which have been evolved, right? Like divide and conquer strategy. So what we are doing, we are just dividing this array based on certain middle element. So let's say middle element we have calculated. How to calculate middle element? This 0 at this 1 plus this n minus 1 divided by 2. Okay. So we can calculate this middle element, right? So let's say the middle element is 5. Middle element is 5. So then the array is getting divided into two halves. Left half, and then the right half, right? So if the element which is to be searched is greater than middle element, am I audible, students?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. If the element which is to be searched is greater than the middle element, if it is greater than the middle element, then we will be searching it into right half. Okay. We will be searching that element in right half. So we will go ahead with this. Okay. And we will just avoid searching in the left half. So again, the n is divided into n by 2 and n by 2. Are you understanding why we have divided it into n into n by 2 and n by 2? Let me okay. So if the element which is to be searched is 9 and the middle element is let's say 5, and then we will search it in only into right part. We will not search it into left part, right? We will not search it into left part. Okay, and this is mid. So these many number of iterations are saved over here. These many number of iterations are saved. Why? Because one complex problem of, let's say here I have taken just 8 examples, but 1 lakh elements which needs to be searched, or indexing which is done, or hashing has to be done. So here that many number of iterations are saved here, right? That many number of iterations are saved. We will be searching only in the right half. Okay, we will search only in the right half. So here we will search, and if again, now here, we don't, so these many number of iterations are stopped, so we don't have to search in this. So let's have a look at this right half again. Okay, just focus on the right half. Why? Because the element is greater than middle element, right? 9 is greater than middle element. So we will not search into this left half. We will go ahead with this only. Right. So we will go ahead with this. So now again, for the right half, we will calculate the middle element. So here, let's say the middle element is 7. Middle element is 7. So again, it will check for the element value which is need to be searched, right? So if it is greater than this middle element, again we will search it only into this particular part, right? We will search only in this particular part. That is, n by 2 is again divided into n by 4 into n by 4, right? So here this is again divided into n by 4, n by 4, right? So again, this is the middle element. Now, what is here, how it is done, again we are solving it recursively. We are solving using recursively, and problem has been divided into sub-problems. So problem has been divided into sub-problems. So number of iterations are saved over here. So what is the role of good computer engineer? Okay, what is the role of good software engineer? To save the number of iterations, to solve the complex problem in a simplistic manner, to make the algorithm so efficient, so it has to take less number of iterations and lesser amount of time complexity, space also has to be saved. So that is, those are the qualities of good software engineer or software designer, okay, programmer. So here, it should not happen that you keep on writing code each and every thing, every time. You should have the reusability concept. You should apply, right? So here what is happening now, in this case what is happening, that you are just avoiding the problems, some sub-problems needs to be solved. Okay, and you are just focusing on the main component only. You are just, now see here, now you are focusing only on 7, 8, 9, you are not focusing on the left out part of the array, right? So now this 7, 8, 9, again the mid is calculated. Now the mid becomes 8. Mid becomes 8. If the mid becomes 8, again the element is compared with 8. Okay? It is now greater than this. So now again we will search only in this particular portion, 8 and 9. Again, mid is calculated. Now if A of mid, it may happen that A of mid is equal to X at some point of time, right? Now this mid will become 9. So it may happen that it is becoming A of mid is equal to the element. Then the element, if it is found, then it's okay. If it is not found, then also element is not found. That message you are giving, right? So here, again, what you are doing in this, we have divided the problems into sub-problems. We have tried to solve it in recursive manner. We have divided the complex problem into sub-sub-problems. And because of that, the number of iterations which have been taken by the algorithm to execute have been reduced. And because of that, time complexity reduces. We are solving the problems parallelly. And we are not focusing on unwanted details. We are focusing only on the necessary details. That is what is happening. Okay? Now that we are going to see more in more detail in divide and conquer, that is unit 2. Okay? But here I have given one example of the recurrence tree method where the n number of elements were, let's say, 8. 8 elements have been divided into n by 2, n by 2. Again, this n by 2, if we need to search for the element, has been divided into n by 4, n by 4, n by 4. Again, n by 4, at some point of time, it will become n is equal to 8. Now, 8 divided by 8, it is going to become 1. Means either the element is found or not found. Okay? So, if that is the case, then how to solve this n is, now it is 2t n by 2 plus t n by 4 plus 8 into n by 8, right? What is the height of this binary tree? It is log n by 2. Log n by 2, now n is was equal to 8, right? So here log 8 base 2, it is equal to 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4, that is the height of the binary tree. Got it? So, so here it is becoming, let's assume n is equal to 8. So 8 was, now this 8 is nothing but in terms of 2 raised to k. So n divided by 2 raised to k is equal to 1. N divided by 2 raised to k is equal to 1. And n is equal to 2 raised to k. Okay. And then this can be written as, this problem is sub, we keep on dividing it into sub-problems in terms of 2. Okay. You may ask, what if there are odd number of elements? Odd number of elements is also possible, like in binary search, let's say array is of odd number of elements, we keep mid as integer. We can select any one value as mid. Right. So 2t n by 2, it is roughly 2t n by 2 plus n. So it is in terms of 2 raised to k, t of n divided by 2 raised to k, that is plus k n. So, we will, now here we have derived this, n is equal to 8, 8 divided by 2 raised to k, that is n is equal to 2 raised to k, taking log on both the sides, we will be getting k is equal to log n base 2. So, the time complexity becomes O of log n base 2. So, this is in case of binary search. Similar is the example of merge sort, right? We have seen this recursion tree method. Now let's come back to this. I hope you have understood what has been taught about the recurrence tree method. Yes or no? Okay. So now here, yes, I'm getting messages. Yes. Okay. Now here you have to see this f of n is equal to 0. If n is equal to 0, if number of elements are 0, then it is going to be 0 only. Otherwise, there may be, this is example. Otherwise, you just keep, check this condition. Condition if n is greater than or equal to 1 and f of n minus 1. This is also one example of recurrence relation. Another example of recurrence relation that we have seen was f of n is equal to 0 if n is equal to 0. Otherwise, if n is equal to 1, if number of elements are equal to 1, then again how many number of times it will affect just one unit of time. And f of n by 2, that is 2 into f of n by 2. Okay, so this we have seen. Now recurrence tree method, I had taken one example of merge sort. Again, this is one classical divide and conquer algorithm. It splits the array into half unless and until you get a single element, and then we just keep on merging that element into auxiliary subarrays, and those auxiliary subarrays again sorted and then merged into final array. Okay. So recursively we are sorting the two half, merges two sorted subarrays into final sorted array. So let's have a look at this. We will see first example. So this is array. This is array 5, 2, 4, 7, 1, 3, 2, 6. Okay, these are the elements. Okay, so these elements, this is array. Okay, so this is array. So we will be sorting it. So first element is compared with the second element. So 2 is lesser, though it will be copied. Then 5 is copied. 4 is copied, then 7 is copied. Then after that, 1 is smaller than 3, then 1, 3, 2, 6. So here, number of elements in the subarray becomes 2. Okay. Then again, it will be checked. 2 is lesser than this 4. Again, it will be checked like this. There we can take several indices. Okay. So here we will take I. Here we will take J. So let's say A of I is compared with B of J. If A of I is smaller than, let's say, C. This is C array. C of K, okay, and this is A of I, and this is B of J, okay, B of J. So A of I compared with B of J, if A of I is smaller, then it will be copied to C of K, auxiliary array C, okay, otherwise, and the pointer is incremented, I plus plus. Now again, A of I is now 5, A of I is 5. It is compared with B of J. Now here again J is incremented. It is compared with B of J. 5 is compared with 7. If it is lesser, yes, 5, A of I is lesser, so 5 will be copied. And then now this array is exhausted, subarray is exhausted. Means it is finished copying. So whatever is the remaining element in the next subarray is copied. Okay, here. Again, now what about this? Again, here this is A and this is B. And the entire, this we can represent it by I and J. A of I is compared with B of J. If 1 is lesser, it will be copied to C of K. I is incremented. A of I is again compared with B of J. That is 2. So 2 will be copied. Then 3 will be copied. 6 will be copied. Likewise. Okay, so we have copied this element into the auxiliary array. Here, what is the disadvantage of this merge sort? We need some auxiliary arrays. We need extra storage space over here. Okay, extra storage space over here. So likewise, we have merged array. Okay, we have merged array. So we have got sorted and merged array. Now here, we will see how it works. What is the algorithm? So if A merge sort is of array A 1 to N, if N is greater than 1, is the number of elements that we check, then only it will enter. Then we will keep on dividing the array, splitting the array. It will be merging from 1 to n, n plus 1 to n, means if we are divided into like ranges, from ranges, first range is 1 to n, second range is m plus 1 to n, and then we will merge. So this was about merge sort and recursion tree method. Okay. This is one example which I would like to take afterwards. Okay, so this was about recurrence tree method. Now, this is an example. Wait, let me, this is for the derivation that you have to prove that root 2 log n is equal to O of root n. I would like to give this example in tutorial. Okay, I will give this example in tutorial and I will solve it for you. Okay, now we will stop here for recurrence tree. Now we will start with the master theorem. I think some time is left. Some more amount of time is left. I think 15 minutes are left. So we will see now master theorem. Okay. Now, is this master theorem open in front of you? Okay, master theorem is visible. That adob has been switched with the master theorem. Okay. See, now in the previous one, we have seen that there are three methods. Okay, three methods. What are the three methods? There are three methods. Let me check for the doubts if any. Yes, you have any doubts till now? Okay. Okay, fine. No doubts. Okay. We will start with the master theorem. Now, there were three methods to solve the recurrence relation. One was back substitution, right? That we have seen. The second was recurrence tree method, right? That we have seen. Of course, you need to have more examples on this. This we will cover it up in tutorial section, right? We will try to solve more recurrence tree and back substitution like problems. Now, three methods were there for solving recurrence relations. Recurrence relations can be solved with the help of three methods. One is back substitution, recurrence tree method, and third one is master theorem. Okay? Third one is master theorem. It's very simple. It's very, very nice, or you can say again, this what I have done, it has taken from Corman only. Yes. It is from, it's very simple and it's like a cookbook. Cookbook means what? You are having like a recipe. Okay? You are having the, while cooking something, you have the recipe, right? Right. So it is also a kind of recipe. If this is the case, then do this. What it says is, let me show you one example. If this is the case, then do this. Okay? So here they are telling us that if this is the case, then solution is this. Second case, if another is the condition, another case is there, then this is the solution. Case 2, if this is case 3, if this is the case, then this is the solution. So that's why it is called as master theorem provides a cookbook solution in asymptotic terms. It provides us a cookbook solution. Cookbook means kind of a recipe in asymptotic terms using big O. Notation for recurrence relation of type that occur in the analysis of many divide and conquer algorithms. So it was popularized by the canonical algorithms textbook, that is Introduction to Algorithms by Corman. So it is there in the Corman. Okay, and it is, Corman is like a Bible of algorithm. You should read that book. Okay, so not all the recurrence relations can be solved with the help of master theorem. We are going to discuss those cases also which cannot be solved with the help of master theorem. Okay, now let's have a look at this. Consider a problem that can be solved using a recursive algorithm such as the following. So let's say P, n of size of the problem. Size of the problem is defined as, if n is less than 1, then exit. Okay, if n is less than 1, then you don't have to worry, you just exit. Otherwise, if n is greater than 1, then do this. What you have to do, I have given you just now one binary search example, right? YouTube and let's say on Drive also. I hope last one lecture is not uploaded. Last two lectures are not uploaded. I will upload it because recording was, there was disturbance in the recording. Okay. So, I'll upload it. No problem. So, procedure T of n, size of the problem is there, and do the work of account of f of n. This problem is divided into n by b. What is this b? B is nothing but the number of subdivisions. Like we have seen binary search, right? N by 2, n is, okay, here again, in order to explain you this, n is divided into n by 2. Yes. It is divided into 2 halves, right? This n by 2 again. N by 4, okay, n by 8, n by, So this is C of n by b, n by b, repeat for a total amount of time, that is C of n by b, right? So in the above algorithm, we are dividing the problem into a number of sub-problems recursively. Each sub-problem is being of size n by b. This can be visualized as building a call tree with each node of the tree as an instance of one recursive call and its child node being the instances of subsequent calls. If you have not understood, don't worry. What it says is, we are dividing the problem into a number of sub-problems recursively, right? We have solved it into sub-problems. Sub-problems have been solved recursively. Each sub-problem is of being of size n by b. It can be visualized as building a call tree with each node of the tree as an instance of recursive call. So we are having the recursive call instances. Okay, so here what if, let's have a look at this recurrence relation T of n, A into T of n by B. Okay, so now here we were having this example, right? So what equation we had derived here in this case, n was divided into n by 2, n by 2. T of n is equal to some constant plus this, plus what? 2 times T n by 2. So what is A over here? 2 times, huh? It is 2 times. So A is nothing but the multiplication factor, right? A is nothing but multiplication factor. T, n is the problem size divided by 2 means number of times it has been divided, right? So A into T of n by b. I hope you are understanding this. Plus f of n. F of n is nothing but some constant or other some work that algorithm has to do, okay, in order to perform properly. Okay, we will more focus on this f of n. We'll put some focus on this f of n. So what it says is the master theorem concerns the recurrence relations of the form T of n is equal to A means how many number of times it has been divided. A into T of n by b plus f of n. So this is a generic form of the master theorem. What it says is, in the application to the analysis of a recursive algorithm, the constants and functions take on the following significance. What is that? N is nothing but the size of the problem. A is nothing but the number of sub-problems in the recursion. Number of sub-problems which are there in the recursion. Okay? And A n by b is nothing but the size of each sub-problem. Okay? Size of each sub-problem. Okay, so this is 4 number of times. This is 4 T n by 4. 4 T n by 4 plus. What is plus? Plus is n by 2 plus n by 2 becomes n, right? This n. So 4 T n by 4 plus n, that is 2n. So now in this case it will become 4 T n by 4 plus 2n. Got it? This n by 4 divided 4 number of times plus n by 2 plus n by 2, that is n, plus this n. So it will become 2n. So 2n plus 40 n by 4. So likewise you can write the equation. So here n is nothing but the size of the problem. This is total size of the problem. Okay. And A is nothing but the number of sub-problems. Number of times the sub-problems are there. And n by t is nothing but the size of each sub-problem. Okay, and f of n is nothing but, look at this, f of n is nothing but the cost of the work done outside the recursive call. Outside of this recursive call, whatever cost of the work which has been done, which includes the cost of dividing the problem and the cost of merging the solutions to the sub-problem. Okay, let's see the example over here. Now there are certain cases. I told you this is a cookbook. Cookbook means the cookbook which is telling you that do this, right? cookbook is telling you what you have to do. Okay, we can finish this case one. I think 5 minutes left. It is 9:53. Okay, 9:53. We can finish this case one. We will. Don't worry. I will just. In the next lecture also we will continue with this. So what it says is, if f of n is equal to theta of n raised to c, if it is theta of n raised to c. Now look at this example. Instead of going to this directly to the complexity, don't focus on the complexity. Let's try to make the thing simple. So what is that? T of n is equal to 8 into T of n by 2 plus 1000 n square. Okay. 8 into T of n by 2 plus 1000 n square. So what is 8 over here? If we write it in terms of T of n is equal to A into T of n by g plus some f of n. Right. So what is A over here? A is nothing but 8. What is B? B here it is 2. F of n is equal to 1000 n square. Okay? 1000 n square. F of n is equal to 1000 n square. So f of n is of the form. What it says is f of n is of the form theta of n raised to c. It is theta of n raised to c. What is c value over here? This is of the form theta of n raised to c. No? If f of n is theta of n raised to c, then here c is equal to 2. Right? C is equal to 2. A value is what? A is equal to 8. G is equal to 2. So here, then, what is the time complexity? If this is the case where C is greater than, C is lesser than log A base B. What is C value here? 2. It is less than log. What is A? 8 base 2. Log 8 base 2 is what? Log 8. 2 raised to 3 is equal to 8. No? 2 raised to 3 is equal to 8. So that is log 8 base 2 is nothing but 3. And what is C value over here? C value is theta of n raised to C. That is 1000 n square. So C value is 2. 2 is lesser than 3. Yes. Here f of n is equal to 1000 n square means n raised to C. If f of n is of this form, theta of n raised to C, C is equal to 2. And C, where provided C has to be lesser than log A base B. Log A base B, log 8 base B. B C value is 2. So log 8 base 2, that is 3. And if 3 is greater than this C, that is 2, then what is the time complexity? Time complexity is of the form theta of n raised to log A base B. Log A is what? Log A is 8 divided base B. So log 8 base 2 is nothing but 3. So it is of the form T of n is equal to theta of n cube. N raised to 3. Right. Theta of n raised to 3. Wait a minute. Can you see this? Okay, can you see this at all? Screen is visible, no? Okay, so this was case one. This was case one. Have you understood this, students? Have you understood? Any doubts in case one? Any doubts regarding master theorem? Yes or no? It's clear, no? Okay, so we will stop here. Okay? We will stop here. Ask the doubts in today's lecture if any. You can ask me through chat box or you can unmute yourself and you can ask me the doubts. 3 minutes left. Okay, did you stop over here? Thanks for the today. Okay?